Hello everyone, welcome to our channel M2K Tutorials. So today we're going to discuss about how we can debug our code in Chrome, especially JavaScript code. So guys, you already know, for this any development purpose, debugging is very important things. So first thing, to be a good developer, you have to be write good code, obviously. Then you also need to debug that code, right? So debugging is as important as writing your code, because if you face some issue and if your code is not behaving as you required, so you need to debug that code, right? And in order to debugging in JavaScript, Chrome developer tool provide you some fantastic ways to debug your code, and today we're going to see those techniques, tips and tricks. So please watch this video till the end and let's get started. So guys, to demo these techniques, I have created this index.html where I have my external script debugging in chrome.js, and in our debugging chrome.js we added two simple functions. One function is adding two values a and b, and the second multiplied value by function, getting one value and then the other parameter as factor, and then multiplying that factor to that value and returning the multiplied value. And here we are just calling those method add and multiplied value by, and we just checking those values. So this is very simple example of any code. So here we have two function and two lines. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just debug this code and we'll get to know at runtime what is the value coming in added value, what is the value coming in multiplied value, and then what is going inside these methods. We will gonna see it at runtime while debugging our code in Chrome. Okay, so for this, let's open our Chrome browser. Here I already open our index.html file, and what we gonna do, we first need to open the developer tool of Chrome. So to do that, we can click right click and then go in inspect, and developer tool will be open. The second way, in Windows, in Mac there can be other options. In Windows you can just press F12 and your developer tool will come. The other way is that you go into these three dots, go in more tools and then go in developer tools. So these are the three ways you can open your developer tool in Chrome. So if you open your developer tool, there might be thing that your developer tool open in some other tabs, means like in element, console, network, whatever the last time you have opened that developer tool. So what you need to do, you need to just first come to the source tab, and in the source tab you first need to open your JavaScript file which you have added in your HTML. So if you see in this left panel, you can see your files are here, index.html, debugging in chrome.js. You can open by clicking on this debugging chrome.js and this script file will be open. But problem is that when you are dealing with, you know, any large project, so there will be tons of file here, and then you will need to search those file one by one, and you need to find the file which you have interest on. So the short form to open any file is Control P in Windows. Whatever I'm shortcut I'm telling you, it's in Windows. So in Mac, you will see some of the instruction by Chrome itself, that how, what is the button you need to use. So please follow that one. Okay, so I'm just talking about the Windows perspective. So here you need to click on Control plus P, and when you do that, there will be search box will be open. Okay, now here you need to type your file where you want to debug your code. So I want to debugging in chrome.js, and see guys, whenever I opened that index.html, because this function I was calling in like in like normal JavaScript file, and JavaScript file executed automatically whenever it had it. So this obviously is already getting executed, right? So first thing we need to do, we need to put the breakpoints. So what is the breakpoints? So let's say I want to first check the value of added value. Okay, so what I need to do, I need to go this line number 9 and I just need to click once here, and you see this blue arrow is coming here. Okay, so this is latest version of Chrome, and so it might be there will be might be there is one red dot for you, but you will get to know that this line is getting highlighted, this 9 number line is getting highlighted somewhere. So this is actually breakpoint, and breakpoint ensure that whenever your code is executing, it stop at that breakpoint so that you can debug that code. Now here you can see here in your right panel, if you see there are some of the fields called stack scope. We will be talking in more in our maybe next video, but for now you can see here in breakpoint, you can see whatever the breakpoint you have given here, it's added here. So what number of breakpoint you will be adding, it will be shown here to use to just check, because whenever you are dealing with again multiple and big project and multiple files, it will get overwhelming. So this will keep track of that. Now so whenever your code will be executed and the execution will come into this line, this breakpoint, whenever wherever you are putting this breakpoint, this will make sure that your code get stopped there and it will be available for debugging. Okay, so this is about the breakpoints. Now if you see in this top panel, you will see some of the buttons here. Okay, so this is pause script execution. We're gonna talk about more on those things, and this step over next function call, then step into next function call, then step out of current function, and then step. So and this one is this little button you see, if we click on this one, then your breakpoint will be get disabled and your code will not have any breakpoint. So you don't need to click on that one right now because we are just getting into debugging mode. Okay, we need to debug some things. Okay, so now what I gonna do, I'm just gonna refresh my index.html so that this code again get executed, and you will see that our code will stop here whenever this line will getting executed. So let me refresh it, and now here you can see now this line is getting, it's still not executed because we put our breakpoint. So our execution started from it what would have happened here, it will register this function, then this function, and when execution is coming in this line, our breakpoint said stop, we need to debug this. So this line is still not executed, it's in there, so execution is still left. So as you can see, and if you hover any of the values, you can see that you will see the value of that variable. So here you can see the undefined is because still this line is not executed, so added value don't have anything yet. Okay, because this line is still not executed. Now we need to move ahead. So move to next line, what we need to do, we need to press F10 or this step over next function call button. Okay, F10 or step over next function call button, what it will do, it will move our execution to the next line. So now if you see, this line number 9 is now getting executed, and I can see the added value now have value 15, because what happened in background, add method gets called, 510 got passed and 510 got added and assigned to this added value. Now I can see by just hovering it, I can see the value of 15 in added value. This is runtime, I can see that. Okay, so I'm sure that add function do its work properly. Okay, now the other thing what we can do, we can actually go into the function we can go into the function and debug that as well. So earlier in add section we didn't debug the add, but now I want to debug this multiply value by function now. So what I need to do, and my execution is stopped here and is just going to execute this multiply value by function. So what I need to do, we need to press F11 or this step into next function button. And if I do that, let's say F11, and now you can see, right, you can see now it's into the multiply value by function. And here I can also see that what are the values it's getting from our this line number 11. Okay, so here I can see that 15 is getting passed, that's good. And the factor, so factor I pass 3 and I'm receiving 3, so it's also good. So we get to know that okay, it's working very good now till the time. And now, just because I want to see the multiply value again, whether this multiplication happening correctly or not, so I can just press, like earlier we did for going to the next line, F10 or step over. So I just press F10 and I can see the multiply value was 15 and factor were 3, so multiplied those thing and I am getting 45, so it's all good. Now if I just press F10, that will also bring me to the next line of this one, or it will be we'll get to know the multiplied value function, multiply value. Or what we can do, if we don't want to, let's say there may be more than two lines here in this multiply value by function and we just want to execute this second line and go out of this function, what we can do, we can press shift F11, which is a step out of current function, this button. Okay, either click on this one or press shift F11. Okay, so I'm clicking on this button and now you can see I'm just getting outside of that function and the next line. And now I can also see the multiplied value. So whatever happened here, we already seen that it's multiplying there and then we are getting this value. So this one pretty much okay, we can go to the next line, we can also see, we can go to the function, we can see that. Now I just want this our debugging to be stopped currently for this breakpoint. So what I can do, I can just press F8 or this resume script execution. So as soon as I press F8, and voila, your script is getting now stopped that debugging thing. But if you put two breakpoints, first breakpoint in function add and then I am putting second debugger here, and let me again refresh it, and now you can see that debugger the first breakpoint was here. So whenever the execution come here, I can see the value which is getting passed. Okay, now I just want to, I don't want to again execute all those things, and I just want to stop my execution whenever the next breakpoint is getting triggered. So I can just press F8 or this resume script execution. So F8, and here I can see just directly it's going to the next breakpoint, it will not stop anywhere else. Okay, F10 is going for one by one line, F8 going to the next breakpoint, F11 if you want to debug any function and if you want to go into that one, and then F8 again if you want to, you know, stop execution after all breakpoint executed. All right, the one thing you can also do, you can just click on these the list which is giving by the Chrome, and if you click on that, you can also see you can go those lines by just clicking on those one. Okay, so this was pretty much is for basic understanding of debugging. We're gonna more go deeper and we will see how to debug any asynchronous function, and in maybe next part we're gonna also see how you can debug the third party libraries which are minified and you're not properly able to see the code as well. So if you like this video, please click on the like button, and guys, this is new channel, so please subscribe to my channel, and we'll see you in next one. Happy coding.